Hello everyone, I am Rajat Arora and today I will be presenting our work SynCan GIF, learning a generative video model from a single GIF. This work was done under the supervision of Professor Yong Jae Lee at UC Davis. So the main motivation for our work comes from the fact that video datasets are inherently much more complex and resource intensive as compared to image datasets. But on the other hand, a single GIF in comparison isn't going to be as complex and will likely require less resources. Also, if you have a snippet which consists of a natural scenes, it is likely to have repetitive periodic motion, like for instance in case of a waterfall or clouds floating through a sky, which is likely to be easier to model. Also, you have models like SynCan and InCan which have shown that it is possible to model the distribution of patches within a single image. So we try to see if you can do this for video snippets as well and what kind of applications you can build on top of it. So build upon the hierarchical generation process of SynCan. So given an input, we will upsample it by a factor of R and add a Gaussian noise to it. This is passed through a series of 3D convolutions to estimate a set of residuals, which when added to the upsampled input will refine it for that scale. This can then be used as the input for the next scale and the process continues. This is guided by two discriminators, one of which takes the entire video snippet as the input and works on the video level, while the other works on a frame by frame level. Apart from these discriminator losses, we also include a color statistics loss, which matches the mean and variance of the color channels of the output to that of the input, which makes sure the color distribution remains realistic. We also include a reconstruction loss to get back the original input sample, which helps in a wide variety of downstream tasks, which we'll be discussing later. To further improve on this model on finer scales, we replace the 3D convolution with the 2D convolution and work on each frame separately. This helps to reduce the number of parameters and thus decrease the training time. Thus, as you can see, our model can successfully model both the patches and their associated motion for a wide variety of scenes, which I'll be showing you in the next slide. For quantitative comparison, we extend single image FID proposed in SynCan to single GIF FID, where instead of patches of a single image, we gather the patches across all the frames of the GIF and compare it against the output GIF. And as you can see, our method does much better as compared to SynCan. We also do an AMT study where each of the workers has access to the video for around 5 seconds and can play the video twice. And nearly 50% of our generated videos were classified as real, which is a very promising result. So here you can see very diverse scenes and you can see random samples which look realistic, which were generated by our model. Apart from these random scenes, you can also generate random samples which are different aspect ratios. So given this as the training input, so you can generate wide variety of different aspect ratios, which is useful for data augmentation. Another application is video super resolution, and as you can see, our results look very sharp and are also temporally consistent. This is done by passing the low resolution input through the fineness generator. It is also useful for seamless composition. So you will take this translated video, downsample it, and pass it through finer generators, which helps to remove the seam and give you a very coherent output. Another important application is motion transfer. So you train your model on this original video and then you can pass a semantically similar image and you can see it has transferred the motion of water as well as the camera to this new image. Though this is not totally realistic, but at the same time, this given the complexity of task, we consider this as a very promising result. Another important application is motion lengthening. So say you are given a very short input snippet which consists of only 8 frames. You can generate samples which are longer than 8 frames. So here we show you 8 frames, 12 frames and 16 frames and all of them look similar to the training samples and also very coherent. You can also do slow-mo. For slow-mo, we model the input as a path in the latent space and instead of passing the entire video snippet to the 3D convolution, to maintain the frame rate same as that of the original, we'll be subsampling the output and as you can see, we can produce a slow-mo video as well. So as you can see, our model can successfully model both the image patches as well as their associated motions for a wide variety of scenes. But on the other hand, a limitation of our approach is that it doesn't work in case of salient objects since it doesn't have any notion of semantic meaningfulness. And so this is an area where further work can be done to how to include semantic meaning to our model. And that's